Schreiber. I'm the owner of the Fencing Sports Academy. We're located in Fairfax City in the Marketplace Shopping Center on the second floor. We've been here for over 7 years. My kids as the driving force behind the whole adventure. They got into fencing hook and sinker relatively quickly. Mm-hmm. We started with a coach and then managing the coach, managing the kids' travel. And it didn't take very long before I realized, actually, I am already managing a fencing club. I may as well make it official. We've been in Fairfax City the whole time of our existence, which is over 11 years. And we love being in Fairfax City. The Fencing Sports Academy had 3 fencers that trained at FSA in the World Championship in Cairo last year. Northern Virginia and Fairfax City is kind of the center for women's FA right now, especially in the junior and cadet category. All 3 team members in junior and cadet came from Northern Virginia or Northern Virginia area. So that is a first, but it gives credit to how fencing has developed in this area over the last 10, 15 years. For the mindset of a fencer, being able to assess people without having to give into what you may think people want you to do and doing it. The medals and the trophies, they're kind of the train stations where you get your ticket punched. But the journey is what you see here in the club, which is the training to become confident, to try this, to try that, to adapt, to learn, to make friends, to learn about your friends, to have a very structured idea about what your training needs to look like to get to the goal that you want to go to. But at the same time, understanding you're not an island, even though it is an individual event. And there are team events in fencing, and they are the best events in fencing because that is where everybody gets excited, where you have teams, where all of a sudden people yell. And some of the fencers are actually better in team events because they may drop a touch if it's an individual event, but if it's a team event, this is for the team and we're gonna get that one. Fencing events are really very civilized events with a lot of sportsmanship and sportsmanlike conduct that is still very much encouraged and very much enforced.
My name is Jasmany Diaz Hernandez. I am a PE coach and foil coach working here in Fencing Sport Academy, one of the best clubs in the DC area. So I have been here working for 5 years at this point. It's an amazing experience in this 5 years working in this high level fencing club. I started fencing when I was 10 years old in my country, Cuba. I was a competitive fencer for more than 10 years, and usually I step inside the junior national team in my country. And after that, I start to study in the college for the physical education, and I get my degree to start to teach specialty in fencing. I have a lot of good experience in fencing, but my best experience has been like coach.
My name is Hadley Husisian. I've been fencing for 8 years. I'm a high school senior. I'm 18 years old. And I started fencing when I saw the sport on a TV show, iCarly. Since then, I just really fell in love with it. I love the individual aspect of it. I love how much strategy is involved. Some of my favorite memories in the sport most recently was representing the U.S. at a World Cup in Spain. And I was able to make the finals with my friend and teammate also from the U.S. and eventually was able to win it, which was a really fun experience and felt very good to be up on the medal stand and hear the national anthem. I first started fencing internationally for the U.S. when I was in ninth grade. And first started going to tournaments in Poland and Slovakia and Germany. And it was a really scary experience, but it was nice having the team aspect because it's people from all across the country and we get to come together and cheer each other on when I was used to competing against them at the national level. So it was just a really fun experience to train with them, get meals with them, and travel the world with them. And I qualified for my first World Championships in 2020, though that was canceled. And I first competed in World Championships in 2021, and I'm excited to do the same this year. And in the future, I'm really looking forward to competing at World Championships on the national team, show what I can do on the international stage. And I'm also really looking forward to fencing in college at Princeton, which has always been my dream school, so I'm very excited for that. I've been here for more than 8 years now, just over 8 years. When I first came here, I really liked a lot of the coaches here, and I liked how many classes they offered, and I could really stay as long as I wanted because I really loved and enjoyed the sport, and I wanted to spend as much time fencing as possible. And most of all, I really love my coach Guillermo because he's the hardest worker I know, and he's done so much for me, and I'm really grateful for everything he's done.
My name is Coach Giancarlo de la Cruz. So I'll be explaining how fencing basically works electrical. So when we want to use electrical, we use what we call a body cord. This is a body cord. If I want to hook up to the machine, for me, when I touch, the light will go off, I need to grab this end and grab what we call the reel. So the reel, we have a long line that can go up to, let's say, 20 feet, something like that, depending on how far the opponent can go. So what we do, we grab the body cord, we plug it in here, we put the clip, and then we attach this when we have the jacket behind us. So just so you know, the body cord goes through inside my body, and it goes out here where I have the weapon. I will plug this, the front body cord, in front of the weapon like this, and now I'm connected. So how does it work? So the weapon has a tip. Inside the tip, there's two metal dots and a spring. As soon as the metal spring touches the metal dot, it will send a signal through the wire that's inside, well, in between the blade, that will go all the way, the wire will go all the way here through the socket. Now that signal goes from the body cord to the reel. Now, the reel also has a line cord. It's not a body cord because it's a whole lot longer. It goes from here all the way behind and it attaches on the machine. I'm connected on the pink one, so as I said, when I hit, the light will go off. But as I was saying, the signal goes through here, from here, all the way to my back, all the way to the reel, and then all the way to the machine in a matter of seconds. So as soon as I hit, the light will go off. And that's basically how you fence electrical.